one police department is digging deeper into its pocket to clean up meth labs. As 4029 first told you last week, the DEA announced federal funding used to clean up the labs has run out, leaving the financial responsibility to local law enforcement. Newark 6 tonight, 4029's Kelly Johnson gives us an inside look at how the Fort Smith Police Department is handling the extra burden.
These may look like household items, but when combined, they're components of a meth lab. Seizing a meth lab isn't quite as easy as just removing the components from the home or vehicle.
Brand new to the narcotics unit of the Fort Smith Police Department are these Wildland fire suits. They are designed specifically for dealing with the dangerous chemicals meth labs produce.
Phosphine gas is toxic at 0.003 parts per million. So a very small amount of a phosphine gas and you're dead.
At almost $1,000 a piece, they're just the first step in what is a very long, very expensive lab cleanup process.
Realistically, we could be looking at $60,000 or $70,000 for cleanups, and that's just to remove the chemicals that we see.
Fort Smith Police Sergeant George Lawson says the average meth lab cleanup cost in Fort Smith is $2,000, with federal funding gone. We asked Congressman Womack what he thinks of the issue.
You know, in this last round of cuts under the continuing resolution, many really good and worthwhile programs have been affected. But the bottom line is the bottom line. Our deficit right now is over $1.5 trillion in 2011. We can't continue this lifestyle.
Lawson says what makes this even more difficult is an increase in the number of labs found. Last year, they reported seizing 16 meth labs. So far this year, they've seized 6. Lawson says at this rate, they may see an upwards of 30 lab seizures this year. But funding or not, they'll keep going.
We would not turn a deaf ear. If we find out that there's someone that has a lab and we're able to get a search warrant or stop a car, we're going to do it.
In Fort Smith, Kelly Johnson, 4029 News.
And Fort Smith police say there is enough money in their state asset forfeiture fund to clean up the cost right now, at least for now.